Now to the new developments in the search for William Tyrrell this morning. A car that once belonged to his foster grandmother has been seized in Sydney and taken to a secure facility for forensic examination. Police worked through the night searching his foster grandmother's property in Kendall, where the little boy was last seen alive. Detectives used a chemical called luminol to test for any blood. The investigation is now focused on one person of interest, his foster mother. Joining me now is criminologist at the University of Newcastle, Dr. Xanthi Mallett. Morning to you. Police have seized this car and they're using luminol technology as in this latest search. What are they looking for?
They're looking for blood residue, so that will actually show up if there's any blood at all in that vehicle or around the home. So they did some significant searching yesterday using this technology, which could still show up even after 7 years.
So would they not have searched this car beforehand?
I don't believe this car has been searched before, no. But so there have been many suspects over the years, but really the foster family were ruled out quite early on. So this is a new line of inquiry.
They're also searching this garden bed. They're digging up the garden bed. It is 2,622 days. That garden bed all around the house has never been searched. Is that a mistake?
Well, I guess it depends on which way the investigation was going. Clearly, they have new information which has not been released to the public, so they're now following up on those leads and searching very thoroughly in that area, potentially just to exclude it because they're also looking at the three areas outside of Kendall, but they are being very thorough.
So a lot of people would say that's a lot of years. What is this luminol stuff and what could they be finding in a garden bed this many years later?
It's a chemical that will show up under light. So, you know, if under the right circumstances you spray luminol, if there's blood traces or a significant amount of blood, so they're looking at whether William may have fallen off the balcony. If that had happened, there's likely to be a significant blood loss and that would show up even years later.
Are you surprised that this many years later they're going back and testing all these theories now?
Well, I guess it is a significant length of time later. They have had a lot of people to look at over the years, a lot of different theories. There have been many different directions in which the investigation has gone. They have had a review recently, so obviously new information has come to light that has taken them back to this property, so they're following that procedure.
We've also got the police commissioner saying we inherited a mess of an investigation.
Yeah, it's not great, is it? I think they will certainly be looking at their procedures, especially in light of the Cleo Smith case in WA. You know, Cleo was found, thankfully, safe and well after 19 days. So I think they will be looking at that and looking at their procedures in this case and seeing what can be learnt.
Xanthi, thanks for your time.
Thank you.